The church I see is unforgettable, once encountered, never forgotten. It takes delight in being enigmatic and challenging religious stereotypes. Its constant readiness to reinvent itself and stay one step ahead of the culture around it keeps it from irrelevant obscurity. I see a church that's everywhere. It turns up wherever love is needed. Its passion spills out from its dynamic gatherings into every area of its people's lives, making them movers and shakers wherever they're strategically positioned in life. I see an extravagant church. It serves God without counting the cost of time, money, or effort. Its worship is sacrificial and never half-hearted. Grace, patience, and kindness flow freely to one another and to the needs of the world around it. I see an engaged church that can't rest while there's injustice, loves all of God's creation, and while it passionately calls on God to intervene, never substitutes prayer for caring action. I see an inclusive church where men, women, and people of all ages, nations, and backgrounds can serve God equally and nobody feels in the minority. A church which is high on grace and low on judgment. A church where people can bounce back from failure and where perfection is attributed to God alone. I see a church where friendship is paramount. Prioritized friendship with God enriches and galvanizes all of its earthly friendships. It's a church whose social life is as strong as its spiritual life. I see a mobilized church where people reach their fullest potential, where people are equipped through teaching and personal encouragement to squeeze the most out of life and put the most back in. A church where everyone knows that they are indispensable and integral to the vision. I see a supernatural church, passionate about the Holy Spirit, a church where Jesus is seen to be alive and the first place people come when they need a miracle. A church where prayer, personal and corporate, is a priority and a joy. I see an easy church. Easy because it's obsessed with Jesus and not with self and its efforts. He is our righteousness and our hope for change. The kingdom, the power and the glory are not ours to strive for, merely ours to receive.